Hello friends, welcome to my channel. I am Sangeeta and you are watching my channel Simple and Easy Recipes by Sangeeta. If you are watching my channel for the first time, I request you to please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon to get my future video notifications. It's Christmas time and Christmas is incomplete without rich dry fruit cakes. In my last episode, I have shown the plum cake version with eggs. Today, I will show the eggless version of plum cakes. In plum cakes, you need to soak your dry fruits before to absorb more moisture in them. I have soaked the dry fruits in orange juice. I will put that link in my description box. You can check it from there. I'm going to bake this cake in gas in a kadai. I have taken one kadai and I'm just putting a layer of salt as the base. I have reused this salt whenever I bake in cooker or kadai. Now put a steel stand and cover the lid and preheat this for 10 minutes in high flame. Now in the meanwhile, we'll make the cake tin ready. I have taken one 8-inch round shaped aluminium cake tin. I have taken enough amount of butter and I am going to apply it nicely into the cake tin. Now this trick will help the cake to come out nicely from the cake tin. Now cover the cake tin with butter paper and again apply some butter into it. Now finally, dust some plain flour, that is maida, into it. Now keep this aside and now we will prepare our cake batter for the cake. I am making this eggless cake. So for this I have taken 1 cup, that is 250 ml room temperature milk. I am adding 2 teaspoons of vinegar into it. Let it sit for few minutes and our buttermilk is ready. And now I am adding 100 gram unsalted butter in a bowl. We'll also add little buttermilk into it and now with a hand whisker or with an electric beater, mix this. Now I'm adding 1 cup, that is 250 gram brown sugar. I have just powdered the sugar in mixer grinder. Now just mix the brown sugar with the buttermilk and butter. Slowly add the rest of the buttermilk. On a high speed, I am beating everything for 5 minutes. Also scrape off the sides and edges. Now I'm adding maida, that is all purpose flour, 1.5 cup, that is 375 gram. I'm adding baking powder, 1.5 teaspoon of baking powder. Half teaspoon baking soda. Now mix everything very well. Fold it gently. Now here I have taken few cloves, one small nutmeg and one cinnamon stick. We'll make a fine powder of this. Now we'll add 2 teaspoons of vanilla essence into our cake batter. We'll also add the cinnamon, nutmeg and cloves powder. I'm also adding orange zest. Use a grater to grate the zest. Do not use the white portion, only add the orange color part. Just add the orange color part, don't add the white portion, it will taste bitter. Now similarly, we'll add one lemon zest also, little. you need to give. This will add the beautiful aroma in your cake. Now mix everything very well. Just fold it gently. And you can see the final batter. Now we will add our soaked dry fruits. I have already given this video. You can check this video in my description box. I have soaked this dry fruit in orange juice. Plum cake is incomplete without these dry fruits. You need to soak these dry fruits before to absorb more moisture into it. If you are soaking in orange juice, then minimum 2 hours is enough, and maximum you can soak it for 1 or 2 days. And now pour this batter in the greased cake tin. After you finish pouring the batter, level it and tap the cake at least 10 times. This will help to release the air bubbles and will help the cake to bake evenly. I have taken some dry fruits. I'm adding maida, that is all-purpose flour, to it. Now I will decorate these dry fruits on top of my Christmas cake. Now by adding maida or flour will help the dry fruits to stay as it is on top. Otherwise, if you do not add maida, all the dry fruits will go inside. And now put the cake tin inside the preheated karai. Close the lid and reduce the flame. Now bake the cake in low flame for 2 hours. The speciality of this cake is it takes longer time to bake. So do not bake in high flame, otherwise the inside will remain uncooked and soggy. After 1 hour, just check it once. It's still not done. Again cover the lid and wait for another hour, and finally after 2 hours it's done. Check it with a skewer or with a toothpick. It's coming out clean. So it's done now. Now allow this to cool in tin for at least 2 to 3 hours. And then enjoy serving your friends and family. I hope you like this video. If you like this, then do like it, share it, and please subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to everyone. Bye.